Scientists at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln team up to create the metals of the future. A large interdisciplinary group of engineering researchers is working to improve the performance of metals under extreme conditions. The project is funded by a nearly $1 million grant, mostly from NASA Nebraska EPSCoR.
So the ultimate goal of what we do on our side of things is adding functionality to metal surfaces. And so we use short pulse lasers to modify surfaces on both the micro and nano scale, and we also modify them on chemical level as well.
When we functionalize those surfaces, we put these micro, nano, and atomic scale structures on it such that it has specific properties, just like Mother Nature does on a butterfly wing, for example, or on a lotus leaf that causes water to run off of a lotus leaf. And now with the femtosecond laser, we can actually functionalize these surfaces in the same way that Mother Nature has been doing.
I think it's just exciting that you can take light and you can actually modify metal surfaces just by applying light to a surface.
We generate these functionalized surfaces, and then Dr. Gogos and Dr. City Dow then take those surfaces and perform heat transfer measurements on them.
We tried to understand how we could enhance heat transfer using microscale and nanoscale surfaces.
The basic research that we're doing has applications in major sectors of the industry.
Power plants use giant steam turbines, so to generate that steam, you have to have some sort of boiler that produces that steam, so this relates directly to that type of an application.
This means that you can transfer heat better in many industrial applications.
And heat transfer, to me, is the most important physical phenomena in nature. And being able to enhance it would make a lot of breakthrough in many technologies.
Well, we are currently funded from a NASA project. And so in the NASA project, we're looking at actually using these surfaces for space applications, where we want to improve the cooling of many of the units that are used on like the space shuttle, for example.
Most of the interesting problems that we are doing today are interdisciplinary problems. A professor with his own narrow, typically, expertise, it's not enough. So we needed to put this large group together to be able to attack such a problem.
Yeah, we have a group of about 25 people working on this project, so it's very multi-interdisciplinary. And so it's extremely exciting about what we were able to accomplish between the different groups.
Collaboration is very important because we are experts in controlling the light and adding functionality to surfaces. We're not experts on applying that functionality, but that's where the mechanical engineers come into play. And so they can then take this functionality and apply it into the real world.
What we envision is almost like an industrial revolution, like where those raw materials, those surfaces, will be functionalized and you can buy them and they will enhance your heat transfer when you design a project, or they will have antibacterial properties or other properties that will be suitable for whatever product a particular industry is after.